Hello friends, welcome to our channel Engineering and Technology Forum. In today's video, you will learn the 8051 microcontroller pin diagram. Let us start with the introduction. The 8051 has got family members 8031, 8751, 89C51, 89C52, DS89C40, etc. The family member of microcontrollers have 40 pins dedicated for various functions such as input, output, read, write, address, data and interrupts, reset, external access, program store, enable, etc. So we will be discussing the 40 pins for the members of 8051 family. The microcontrollers are available in different packages such as Dual Inline Package, DIP, then QFP, RISC-V Flat Package and LNC, Needless Chip Carrier. Then some companies provide 20-pin version of 8051 with reduced number of I/O ports for less demanding applications. So in general, the pin configuration will have the 40 pins and here we are going to study the Dual Inline Package for these 40 pins. Let us start with the pin diagram. As you can see here, this is the dual inline package, 20 pins on this side and 20 pins on this side. Then we have say 8 pins for port 0, then 8 pins for port 1, then again 8 pins for port 2 and 8 pins for port 3 with alternate functions. Then 2 pins are for the external connection of the crystal. Then we have the reset pin, then EA bar external access pin, then PSEN pin. These are the control pins and then ground and VCC. So this makes the 40 pins for 8051. We'll discuss the functions of all the pins in details. Let us start with VCC and VSS. The VCC pin is connected to plus 5 volt supply voltage. A 125 milliamps current is drawn from the supply and maximum power dissipation rating is 1 watt. Then VSS, this is the ground pin for the supply which will be used for the reference. Then next, XTAL1 and XTAL2. These two pins are the oscillator pins to connect the crystal oscillator of nominal frequency of 12 MHz or 11.0592 MHz. XTAL is an input to the inverting oscillator amplifier and XTAL2 is the output from the inverting oscillator amplifier. The quartz crystal is connected to the XTAL1 and XTAL2 pins. The two capacitors of 35 pf are connected as shown in figure. You can see this figure. This is capacitor C1 and C2. Both are of 30 picofarad. They are connected to the other, say one terminal of the capacitor connected to the ground and they are connected in this fashion and the crystal is connected here between XTL1 and XTL2. That is for generation of the clock. Then further we can use the XTL1 and XTL2. Say here if you are going to use the frequency source other than crystal oscillator, then we can use the say TTL oscillator. At that time it will be connected to XTAL1 and XTAL2 will be left as it is. You can see here XTAL2 there is no connection and here XTAL1 will connect the external oscillator signal. You can see the pins for this XTAL1 and XTAL2. They are 19 and 18. Then let us go to the next pin, that is the RSTP, pin number 9, you can see here. The reset pin is an input and active high, normally low. Upon applying a high pulse to this pin, the microcontroller will reset and terminate all activities. So it is used for resetting the microcontroller. This pin is often referred to as power on reset. Then activating a power on reset will cause all the values in the register to be lost, and the registers will have these values after the reset. Reset value of some 8051 register after reset. You can see here PC will be 0000, then DPTR will be 0000, then accumulator will be 00, it is 8 bit, PSW is 00, stack pointer is 07, again it is 8 bit, the value will be 07, then B register is 00, and all the ports P0 to P3, 4 ports, they will have FF on their pins. So these will be the values, and here for PC we must place the first line of source code in ROM location 0000. So after every reset it will go to that location and execute the program from there. Then let us go to the next part of RST. Now in order for RST input to be effective, it must have a minimum duration of 2 machine cycles. In other words, the high pulse must be high for minimum of 2 machine cycles before it is allowed to go low. So this is done with the help of this resistor and capacitor combination. This 10 microfarad capacitor is connected with 8.2K resistor, and then this part is connected to the reset pin. So reset pin is pin number 9. Then let us go to the next pin, that is the external access, EA bar. Now external access is an input pin and must be connected to VCC or ground. Now all come with on-chip ROM to store programs and have an external code and data memory. See, this external code and data memory, maximum memory will be 64K, and when we want to use the external memory at that time. Now when EA pin is connected to VCC high, then it can execute program from the internal program memory, and when it is connected to ground, to indicate that code or data is stored externally, that is for external access of the memory, this pin is used. So it must be connected to ground, it is active low. So this is pin number 31, EA, and again it is used for the programming part in case of ROM. So it is supplied with the particular voltage for the program. Then PSEN bar and ALE. The PSEN program store enable is an active low control signal. This PC is connected to the OE pin of the external memory. OE means output enable. So for external code memory, PSEN bar is equal to 0, and for external data memory, PSEN is equal to 1. So depending on the value of PSEN, will choose the data memory or the code memory. Then ALE pin is used for demultiplexing the address and data bus when 8051 is interfacing with the external memory. So port 0 provides the low byte of address bus, that is A7 to A0, and data bus D7 to D0. When ALE is equal to 1, port 0 is used as address, and when ALE is 0, it is used as data bus. Then IO port pins. Here you can see in the figure, we have 4 ports P0, P1, P2, P2 and P3. Each uses 8 pins. You can see these are the pins of port 0, that is 32 to 39. Then port 1, 1 to 8. Then port 2, 21 to 28. And port 3, 10 to 17. All the ports upon reset are configured as output. So as we have discussed the reset pin, so all the ports are configured as output and it will have the value 1111, that is FF for 8 bit. So they are ready to be used as input ports by the external device. They are the output ports. Then let us see the ports in details. Port 0, that is P0.0 to P0.7. Again, it is designated as AD0 to AD7. You can see here. Now, port 0 is also designated as AD0 to AD7. When connecting to an 8051 as an external memory, port 0 provides both address and data. Then 8051 multiplexes address and data through port 0 to save pins. Then ALE indicates if port 0 has address or data. If ALE is 0, it provides data. If ALE is equal to 1, it has the address. Then let us go to the port 1 and 2. Now in 8051 base system with no external memory connection, both port P1 and P2 are used as simple input-output ports. But in case of external memory, then port 2 must be used along with port 0 to provide the 16-bit address for the external memory. Here P0 provides the lower order 8 bits, that is A0 to A7, and P2 provides the upper 8 bits of 16-bit address, that is A8 to A50. Then at that time it cannot be used for input-output operation. Then let us go to port 3. Now port 3 can be used as input or output port, and it has additional alternate functions of providing some, say, extremely important signals. Now you can see the pins of port 3 here, and you can see in this figure the different pins, say P3.0 is used for as RXD receiver data, and P3.1 is used as transmitter data, TXD, that is for the serial communication. Then P3.2 and P3.3, they are used for the as a external interrupts. So this is INT0 and INT1. Then P3.4 and P3.5, they are used for the timers T0 and T1. Then P3.6 is used for the write signal, and P3.7 is used for the read signal for the external memories. So these are the additional or alternate functions of port 3 along with input and output. Then let us move on to the summary of the pin description. Here we have discussed VSS and VCC. So this is the ground pin, and VCC is the pin which is connected to plus 5 volt supply, and the rated current is 125 milliamps. Maximum power dissipation is 1 watt. Then this is port 0. Port 0 is an open drain bidirectional I/O port. Port 0 is also the multiplex lower order address and data bus during access to the external program and data memory. So it will be used for these two functions. It has dual function. Then port 1 is 8-bit bidirectional I/O port. Then port 2 is again 8-bit bidirectional I/O port, but it serves as higher order address bus for the external program memory and data memory that use the 16-bit address. Then port 3 is an 8-bit bidirectional I/O port, and also serve as a special feature, that is alternate function, as I have just now explained to you. Then the RST pin reset, say a high on this pin for two machine cycle while oscillator is running, resets the device. Then ALE, address latch enable, output pulse on latching the low byte of the address bus during an access to the external memory. So that is for latching the address. So demultiplexing of the address and data bus. Then program store enable, PSEN. It remains low while fetching the external memory, program memory. During internal program memory acquisition, the pin is high. So it's a signal which is active low. Then EA bar or VPP, external access enable, programming supply voltage. Now EA, here particularly EA bar, must be externally held low to enable the device to fetch code from external program memory location. If EA bar is held high, the device executes the internal program memory. So this is what we have already discussed. This pin is also receives the programming supply voltage VPP during the flash programming. So that is for particularly 89C5 series of microcontrollers. So with this, we come to the end of the video. If you have understood and liked the video, please press the like button and share with your friends and subscribe to our channel. Then if you have any questions, you can find me at Twitter @UGokhale. Then by email also you can contact me, ullaskumargokhale@gmail.com, and on Instagram gokhaleullaskumar. Then thanks for watching. Have a good day. I have you now.